This is so tasty. I think eggs are probably the most comforting food known to man. That egg takes the appam and stew to a whole new level.
In the fast-paced world that we live in, where the old is constantly making way for the new, it's great to have institutions that root us to the convivial traditions of the past, that transport us to a glorious bygone era, the good old days, as some would say. I met one such institution in Bengaluru. KOSHY’S Parade Cafe, or KOSHY’S as it is popularly known by the city's denizens, began as a bakery in 1940. A decade later, the restaurant came into being. I'm told royalty, prime ministers and presidents have dined here. The space still holds a vestige of its glorious past in its atmosphere, traditions and of course the food that they serve. As you step into KOSHY’S, you're immediately transported back into the good old days. It's amazing when you think of the transformation that Bengaluru has made from that into what it is today. KOSHY also serves as a hub where Bengaluru converges. So if you walk in any given morning, any given time of the day, you'll find people from all walks of life that come into KOSHY’S, whether it's for their customary cup of coffee, whether it's for their breakfast, whether it's for the tasty sandwiches that they do with that delicious soft bread. I caught up with Prem Koshy, third generation co-owner of this landmark Bengaluru establishment. So KOSHY’S of course began as a bakery in 1940.
Yeah, it began as a store, as a what we call a convenience store. But my grandpa actually started, he was a banker to start with. Second World War, literally the bank was wiped out.
Okay.
Instead of going back to Kerala, so he stayed and he said, I will grow this thing back again and we will all recover again. Actually, he was, they used to say, the bank manager used to come in a Daimler. My dad and uncle used to be dropped to school in a Daimler. And then, a year or two later, there he was on a cycle, going home to home, getting the ration, which was the flour, £1 was given to you. Okay, made it easier for them to bake it instead of baking it at home, which was difficult.
Yes.
Ovens were difficult, yes, to come by, right? So he would collect the flour, come to the Bowring Institute,
okay,
yes, bake the loaf of bread and take it back to them for our nana. And that's how we started right now.
Wow. You and KOSHY’S and everybody out here,
yeah,
are gatekeepers to the good old times.
That's what I claim. So people say, oh, Santosh and you, my brother, says, Santosh and you are your owners of KOSHY’S. I say, no. Man, there's one thing my grandpa would say, you are never the owners, you are the keepers of a space and a service that was, you know, was a responsibility handed to you. I have people who come here who were friends of my dad's before and dad and mom's before I was born. Yeah, have a cold coffee, puff, yes, and break down crying, sobbing, right?
Having learned of the humble yet fascinating beginnings of KOSHY’S, it was time to take a look around this hallowed institution. The pillars.
The pillars, yeah.
Right? I'm sure there's a story to this.
The pillars can talk. Yeah, the pillars can talk, right. On a good day, some of my writer friends have said, Prem, we sit here and lean up against and we will get a story that inspires us.
I also like the way you've preserved all these photographs from the past.
Yeah, this is, look at these. These are some of the really old photographs. Right, I started doing this when I was 7 years old. My grandpa would say, walk around, you go play wherever you want, and wherever you're playing or having fun, clean. So my thing was either come there, Christmas time, sell cakes, just during holidays, right? Or I'm a, you know, the cleaner. So that's where I started. All my friends would be laughing and joking about that, right? So that's the founder master, right?
That's
my grandpa.
Okay.
And that's my dad, who joined him.
All right.
And then my uncle.
You've seen an enormous amount of change.
in the environment, in the way businesses are run,
yes,
in the way restaurants are run today. So all that must pose a challenge when you're trying to preserve something.
Okay, so it's very simple. Wherever you are able to give the best, safe environment, hygienic environment, tasty, nutritious food, people will come.
There's a sense of pride when I see the wait staff here go about their job.
Not sometimes people tell me, oh, you know what, your waiters are a little bit, they think they own the place. I said, well, I think they are in authority or they have put in the time and they, yes, because that's the only way we work together. Money does not motivate, you can't motivate anymore with money.
And there are people who've been here for
30 years, 40 years. Yeah. One day I begged my old waiter, I said, sir, those chata, you have to, you know, it's time to retire, no?
Yeah.
He said, yes, I'm retired, because he would actually be nodding off sometimes, okay? And he would take care of only his favorite customer that came and demanded that he serve them, right? So, and I said, then he says, you know what? You and my grandpa have an agreement.
Yes.
Whichever one went first, whichever one was left behind, he had to look after the rest of the family till his time.
So that's what he is doing.
His responsibility, look after me and my brother and take care of us.
I was hungry now, and a tour of Koshy's kitchen is just what I needed to whet my appetite.
Breakfast is just picking up here at Koshy's, and you got some of these dishes that are going out. Some of these dishes I'm certainly going to try. Of course, the classic club sandwich, the old-fashioned style.
Yeah.
And of course, there's a chicken liver on toast, the omelets, and I think this, I suspect, is the mutton cutlet. The mushrooms on toast.
Baked beans on toast.
The baked beans on toast. The baked beans that are prepared from scratch here.
Yes.
We're going to taste a lot of that on the table, but we're going to find out how the legendary coffee at Koshy's is brewed.
As you can see, so this is the coffee area.
And this is the filter in which the coffee is.
Yes, that's right. So it's brewed. One of our super coffee connoisseurs who comes and drinks the black, he says the tinge of that black coffee and the purity of the coffee comes from the metal. And he himself researched it and found that this is a kind of a bell metal, a very, very, very unique combination.
It's an alloy.
It's an alloy, yeah? And so that alloy gives it the taste.
So the coffee is brewed in that?
Yes.
Where does the coffee come from?
The coffee is very specially brought from Chikmagalur, Coorg and Kerala.
Okay.
The blend is something that my grandfather has left us as a little bit of a secret, actually.
Okay. And you've been making the coffee for how long? How many years?
46 years.
46 years. So he's been pouring the coffee here for 46 years. Wow. So this is the legendary Appam and Stew that is available only on a Sunday.
Sunday, yes.
Prem has been kind enough to make an exception for us today. On a Sunday, we wouldn't be able to walk in here and take the liberty of shooting this restaurant. So he's been making the Appam for how long?
For how long? How long have you been making Appam?
37
years.
Of course, Koshy's serves an assortment of cuisine. We are here for breakfast, but Koshy's serves
968 items.
So this is Koshy's bread.
Bread from Koshy's bakery.
From Koshy's
bakery.
What
is so beautiful about this bread is that we do it the old way.
Okay.
I'm a graduate of the American Institute of Baking. I studied bakery there.
Okay.
But I came back and decided that we would not go that way. We would go the natural way of making bread. Staying away from the bread is a way to trying to stay far away from all the biochemicals. Okay, so we just do pure old method of baking bread. Keep it to the limited number of loaves. We don't go for the big 3,000 loaves a day. Yeah, but that's it.
So that's an oven that's at least 3 decades old that has seen many slices of bread being toasted in it.
And I think that's thousands of slices of bread.
Yeah, millions of slices
that's
of bread.
Yes, toasted
slices
in that.
Of bread that have been toasted in that, and probably all that flavor.
There
still
you go.
Carries
that's
through.
The thing. That's the thing. Sometimes you see the vessels, people say, why are you going on with the same old vessels? That is the most important part, that the vessels then carry the taste.
Having explored the kitchens here at Koshy's, I can't wait to get to the table and taste some of that delicious breakfast fare that's cooking in the kitchens right now for me. The breakfast at Koshy's has well begun. So we're beginning with the vegetarian offerings for breakfast here at KOSHY’S. So there are three toasts that I'm going to try out. The baked beans, and the beans here don't come out of a can. The beans are made from scratch. You can see that shimmer of butter on top. The other popular toast offerings is the mushroom on toast. And then of course you have the tomato and cheese on toast. I'm going to start with the baked beans on toast. As you can see, the baked beans have been generously slathered on this thick slice of bread. And this is a bread that's made in the KOSHY’S bakery. So it's, in a manner of speaking, homemade bread. I'm going to go for it. You taste the earthy flavors of the bean, and then there is that tomato sauce that brings it all together. Very simple in flavors, very clean flavors. All that you taste is the bean and the tomato, but then that's what the baked beans on toast is all about. And the good thing is that you've got the thickness of the bread that carries the weight of the bean and the tomato flavor. And I think that's what makes it very comforting. The mushrooms have been sauteed simply, I think, in some oil or some butter and some garlic that I can see here. And again, topped generously on this thick, chunky slice of toast. If you're a mushroom lover, you'll love the earthiness of the mushrooms. There's very little else that you taste on the palate. You just taste the mushrooms, the earthiness of the mushrooms, the garlic, and then of course the toast. I've got a bit of the tomato on top now. I'm going to take a bite with the mushroom and also the tomato, just to break the flavors as I get ready to tuck into the tomato and cheese. If you're a mushroom lover, you'll love this breakfast. Next, the tomato and cheese. It makes for such a pretty plate. This is certainly very Instagrammable. This looks delicious even before tucking into it. So you've got the cheese that's melted and settled nicely on the tomatoes. And the tomatoes are gooey, halfway between a tomato concuss or a puree of sorts, and then the chunks of the tomato. This is so tasty. So you bite into the acidity of the tomato, you've got that tomato sauce that envelops your palate, and then you've got the savory, slightly salty notes of the cheese that cuts through the acidity, that cuts through the sourness of the tomato. And then of course the bread just cleanses your palate. So you taste the tomato, you taste the tomato sauce, you taste the cheese, and then you have the bread that washes away the flavor of the tomato in between bites of the tomato cheese toast here. I'm told this is one of their popular vegetarian breakfast dishes, and I'm not surprised by it. Simple dish, there's bread, there's tomatoes, and there's cheese, but so comforting. The sort of dish that takes you back to the good old days. And I think that's really what KOSHY’S is all about. As I look around, I see people just enjoying their meals, having conversations. The food is there, the food is important, but it's a part of the overall experience. This is a vegetable cutlet. What is there in this?
This mix. Potato, vegetables.
All mixed vegetables.
This is the mutton.
This is the mutton cutlet. Thank you very much. So if you're looking for a side act to go with your breakfast, the cutlets here come highly recommended. So you've got the vegetarian cutlet and you've got the mutton cutlet. I'm going to start with the vegetarian cutlet first. Because if I taste that mutton cutlet, the vegetarian cutlet is going to have a tough act to follow. This is an old-fashioned cutlet. Of course, you can see the potatoes, and then you've got some other veggies that have come together with the potato to make this vegetable cutlet. It's an interesting cutlet, so I can certainly taste the potato, the starch in the potato, and that crumb. But then there is a creaminess that envelops my palate. As I taste this cutlet, I'm not sure if they have some cheese in this, which perhaps results in that creamy texture, but it's quite unexpected and it leaves you utterly surprised when you taste this. It's been a while since I've tasted this one. I've got the knife and the fork, but I just want to go for it with my hands here. This feels hot and crisp to the touch. Oh, you can see some steam as well. It's been a while since I've had this. This is what a great mutton cutlet is all about. You've got that beautiful crumbed exterior that's holding this flavorful, meaty mince inside. All that you taste is the mellow, meaty flavor of the mince that's in this mutton cutlet. This is a textbook mutton cutlet, an old-fashioned mutton cutlet. This is so good. If you love your meat and you have a breakfast, definitely order one of those mutton cutlets. It's meaty and it's just got the right amount of spicing for the flavor of the meat to shine through. This is a delicious, delicious mutton cutlet. This is Mr. K's Big Easy English Breakfast. So this is for those breakfasts when you feel indulgent. So you've got the eggs, bullseye, you've got the tawa toast. I'm told this toast is fried on a tawa. You've got the homemade baked beans, a nice plum pork sausage, the fries, and then of course you've got your veggies just to balance it all out. You've got the pepper. Yeah. When you smell the pepper, you know that the pepper has been ground fresh. If you don't smell the pepper, well, that pepper has been sitting in that pepper mill for a while. I think eggs are probably the most comforting food known to man. And when you bite into a piece of the eggs on the toast with the baked beans, you get layers of flavor. You have the unctuous, sticky notes of the egg, and then you've got the earthy, almost powdery texture of the baked beans, the tartness of that tomato sauce, and the comforting texture of the bread that acts purely as a vehicle to convey all those flavors to your mouth. Let's taste the pork sausage. It's a slightly dryish sort of a sausage. So I think what the sausage needs is the moist companionship of the eggs, baked beans and toast. A bit of fiber as an interlude to all that egg and protein. As you tuck into your meal at Koshy's, get one of these tables by the windows. Watch the world go by as you stay cocooned in an atmosphere that feels like it hasn't moved in the last half a century or so. I think that's what makes dining at Koshy's really special.
This is Mr.
K's
special ginger punch.
Mr. K's special ginger punch.
Special breakfast in Spanish omelette.
Let's go for the Spanish omelette first. It's got all sorts of meaty goodness that's rolled inside. I think let's slice the omelette so that it reveals what's inside. There's some cheese, there's some mushrooms, there's some chicken, there's some bacon, there's peppers, capsicum. This omelette is one of those that can be a big meal in itself. You taste all that salty, cheesy goodness. You taste the bite of the meat, the delicately flavored chicken, the salty hit of the crisp bacon, and then you have the crunch of the peppers as you bite into them. It looks like roast chicken and it certainly tastes as savory as roast chicken. This is an old-fashioned omelette, but like they say, old is gold. Get a big gulp of this. You can taste the fruits, you can taste the banana, the papaya, perhaps there's some grape as well that's gone into it. And then you have that spike of the ginger. It's not sharp, but it's mellow, but you can definitely taste the flavor, the tone of the ginger as you drink this juice. So you've got all the nourishment that comes from the fruit, and you've got the ginger to give it that added wellness boost. But it's quite a filling drink, so if you have one of these loaded omelets and you have the Mr. K's special ginger fruit punch, you're set at least for 3 or 4 hours. But it's quite delicious. Lovely.
Chicken liver on toast.
Chicken liver on toast.
It's a signature food in the KOSHY’S.
So you know a lot of the food. How long have you been working here?
21 years.
21 years. So you know everybody who comes to KOSHY’S. Thank you very much, Palani. So that was Palani, who's worked at KOSHY’S for 21 years. And that's typical of most of the wait staff here. Most of them have been here for decades and they know each and every customer who walks into this restaurant. Sometimes the customer doesn't even need to place an order. The server knows exactly what he wants and it finds its way to the table. I have my chicken liver on toast. Yet another popular toast breakfast here at KOSHY’S. As you can see, the liver has been tossed in a pan with onions. There's some chili, some pepper, and some pepper sauce, I'm told. If you are a chicken lover, this is one of those must-try, must-have dishes at KOSHY’S. There's very little that gets in the way of the flavor of the liver that you taste on your palate. You've got the onion, so that kind of gives it a bit of a crunch. You've got the pepper, which spirits it up a bit. But all that you taste really is the wholesomeness of that chicken liver. And the chicken liver is cooked perfectly. It's not soft and mushy. It still has that faint bite as you bite into it. The tasty piece of liver. I'm going to be greedy and just scoop up the liver from the liver on toast. And the best part is all that liver gravy that's been absorbed by this piece of bread. It's a mess, but tasty food at times is a mess. So what we have here is a good old-fashioned club sandwich, probably served the way it was 30 years ago. It's not the club sandwich that you will recognize perhaps from what's being served now. This is a club sandwich that goes back. So what makes this club sandwich interesting? So you've got all these layers. You've got the fried egg. You've got the roast lamb. You've got some chicken, the slice of ham, tomatoes, the onions, and some lettuce. And of course, encased in the bread from KOSHY’S bakery. This certainly is a solid sandwich. You taste that bite of that roast meat. You've got the pungent bite of the onions. You've got the creaminess of the egg that envelops it all. And then of course you have the tomatoes. This is not your typical coffee shop club sandwich. This is a club sandwich that has substance. This is a club sandwich that has layers of flavor, layers of texture. If you're a sandwich lover, something to definitely consider checking out here at Koshy's. So folks, this is a very special moment that we're capturing here at Koshy's, because we've got the appams and the mutton stew, which are traditionally served only on a Sunday. And today is a Thursday. So I don't think in the history of Koshy's have they ever served the stew and appam on a weekday. This is something that I've not tasted in a long time. So you've got this appam, very simple stew, with the coconut milk, you got meat and you got the potatoes. So this is a typical Syrian Christian dish. And then of course you have the appam. You have the simple plain appam. And then you have the mutta appam or the egg appam. Pour that stew all over your appam. Let it soak in all that stew. Oh, this is beautiful. You taste the coconut. You taste a hint of the spice that's gone into it. The cloves. And then of course you have the meat. Oh, this is going to be a delicious piece of meat. The meat has soaked in all the flavors of the stew. But because this is a mutton stew, the flavor of the meat shines through the stew. And the appam is a textbook appam. It's soft, fluffy, and springy in the center. And it's got these lace frilled edges, just the way a good appam should be prepared. So ordinarily, this appam would have been enough. But since we have the mutta appam here, we must taste some of the stew with the mutta appam too. So the mutta appam or the egg appam has an egg that's been cooked in the center of the appam. You know, you can dunk your appam into the stew, but I prefer to ladle the stew onto the appam, because that way the appam, as it's sitting there, soaks up all that creamy, coconutty goodness of the stew into itself. And that's what makes it super, super delicious. There you have it. The mutta appam, I've got some of the yolk in here. I've got some of the white of the egg as well. That egg takes the appam and stew to a whole new level. Like they say, you can never really have enough of a good thing. And that's really what they got going here at Koshy's. It's good old fashioned food, made in the simplest of ways, made by cooks who've been making the same dish for decades now. And I think that's what makes it so special and so popular. Only way to end your breakfast here at Koshy's is with their South Indian filter coffee. This is the sort of thing that you need to pick you up after a big breakfast here at Koshy's. I think when you dine at Koshy's, you're stepping into a wonderful time in the past. You're stepping into a wonderful time in Bengaluru's history. I think Koshy's transports you all the way back. It transports you to an era where time stood still, quite in contrast to the hurried, frenzied life that we find ourselves in. I suspect that most of the Bengalurians for whom Koshy's is a habit, in fact for some of them on a daily basis, come here to relive some of their happy times, some of their happy moments from a long time back. And for new Bengalurians, I think Koshy's offers a delicious insight into Nama Bengaluru of the good old days. And I think that's why if you've not been to Koshy's yet, you must come to Koshy's and discover for yourself a glorious slice of Nama Bengaluru. The food is simple, it's not pretentious. It's just the sort of food that you would probably get had you walked into one of these kitchens 30, 40 years ago. But it's tasty and soul satisfying. And I think that's what makes it very special. So until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!